So let's look at deriving the equations for velocity and acceleration, those vector equations, but in three-dimensional space. So we're going to start here. We're not really going to use any proper coding here. So I'm just going to import the images and the filter warnings. Let's look at an example. Now suppose we have an upright spinning cylinder there, which form the basis of a cylindrical coordinate system. Remember those? In this body coordinate system, which is an intermediate frame, any position B can now be expressed in terms of R, theta, and Z. Remember that the origins of this intermediate frame is at A, and A is a point in an inertial reference frame O. So let's have a look and see what that looks like. Here we go. So here's my body coordinate system. I have I hat, J hat, right hand rule, K hat will be straight up. I have my point A, which is referencing my intermediate frame there. And in my intermediate frame, I have this R hat direction, again in a K hat direction. And if I were to look from the top, some angle theta. So that is my body coordinate system. So if I were just to look at position of B in O, it's given by R of B and A, of A and O. So this is A in O plus B and A, B and A. But now I'm going to express B and A in a different form. I'm going to express it as R. I'm going to express it as R in the R hat direction, and Z up in the K hat direction, and theta. But theta you've got to be very careful about. That's looking from the top. It's going to make some angle, but theta is not a vector. Remember, that's not a vector. It doesn't commute, so you can't use that as a vector. So if I were to take the velocity, all I have to do is to remember which unit vectors are not constant. So when I do the product rule for differentiation, I remember to do that derivative as well. That's one thing. I do have to remember though that k hat and k hat is exactly the same vector. Lowercase k hat, uppercase k hat. So if I do take the derivative of k hat with respect to time, it's going to be zero because it is a constant. It does not change with respect to O there. The other thing that I have to remember is that the first derivative of R hat is theta dot theta hat, and the first derivative with respect to T of theta hat is negative theta dot R hat. Remember that from down here. Let me just remind you of that. So at any time t, this is going to be a position vector, and if it rotates in t plus delta t, it's going to be there. So when this delta t is very small, this arc length here is going to be my delta r. And remember that delta r is going to be omega delta t per second times second. So in the theta hat direction, because remember it's rotating in this upper direction. If I just solve for this delta r over delta t, I get omega theta hat. And if I take the limit as delta t goes to zero of this, it becomes ddt of r hat, which is omega theta hat. So there's my r hat. Its rate of change as a body spins is going to be theta dot theta hat. And the ddt of theta hat here is going to be negative in the negative r direction. If that's r, this is negative r. So it's negative omega theta hat. We've seen those 100 times. So taking the derivative for velocity, this first one there is also with respect to the body, to the world coordinate system. So just taking its derivative is very simple. But now for this lot here, I have to do the product rule. So I'm going to get R dot R hat, and then R ddt of R dot, which I now know what it is. And I get for this one, I don't have to do the product rule because k hat is a constant in the O frame, so that's going to be zero. So I'm only left with a z dot k hat. So just writing that out, velocity then is going to be, you can write it like this or like this. That's going to be the velocity of A in the O frame plus R dot R hat plus R theta dot theta hat and Z dot K hat. No problems there. I'm going to repeat the process here for acceleration, remembering that the Z double dot K hat, no problems there. This one is going to be R double dot R hat, and then R dot, which becomes theta hat theta dot theta hat there. And there's three terms there, so I'll have to take the derivative of the first one, the derivative of the second one, derivative of the third term, so each individually, which will leave me with 1, 2, 3 terms, which will be R dot, there's my theta double dot, and yeah, I've already taken the derivative of theta hat, which remember is negative omega dot R hat. So I have all of that, there's two identical terms there. I can just group the terms and I'm left with acceleration in three-dimensional space using an intermediate reference frame expressed in cylindrical coordinates of the acceleration with A respect to O, but then these three unit vectors in the k-hat direction is a z double dot, but in the theta-hat direction I'm going to have 2 r dot omega plus r omega dot or r alpha. And I'm going to have r double dot minus r theta dot or omega squared. Excellent.